Welcome to this series, The Mistakes of Modern Science, which intends to demonstrate that the great names of science are fallible and many of our so-called scientific proofs are false. Once it was the church that protected religion from science. Now it is science that protects science from science. The premise of modern science is that the quantum world cannot be known and can only be revealed by going faster and faster, as the Red Queen said in Alice Through the Looking Glass, and where the expression, down the rabbit hole, is now the axiom of the quantum world. Science may enjoy living in multiple parallel dimensions, where particles can talk to their twins immediately from across the galaxies, and tenured professors can argue about black holes. But, with simple math demonstrated by a person with the name of Miles Mathis, the true hero, not the Mad Hatter or the lovable mad Professor Einstein, science can be knowable again. This paper is titled, Einstein's E equals MC² is wrong. What is interesting is that Einstein's famous E equals MC² is actually missing in his famous paper of September 27, 1905. It is merely implied, and as we shall see, wrongly. The title of Einstein's paper is, Does the Inertia of a Body Depend on Its Energy Content? Its title is of little help. Nothing about smashing atoms and nuclear war, or even matter itself. It is about light emitting from two bodies while the observer moves away from them. Even Einstein's final result, K0 minus K1 equals 1/2 L over C squared times V squared, has to be unraveled. Einstein's comment on this result is, if a body gives off the energy L in the form of radiation, its mass diminishes by L divided by C squared. Using a supposed more modern and universally accepted E instead of L to denote energy, and by algebraically switching sides, it becomes E equals MC squared. But right there is a magic trick, because E0 was defined as the rest energy of the particle. In these words, it said, let there be a stationary body in the system XYZ, and let its energy, referred to the system XYZ, be E0. And L earlier was defined as waves of light of energy 1/2 L measured relatively to XYZ. Therefore, L equals MC squared is Einstein's real final result, because M0 C squared is not the rest energy before or after the emission of the light. It is the change in rest energy. It is the energy equivalence of the planes of light. Part of the complexity of the calculations comes from making the two light sources in his thought problem to be at an angle to the x-axis. And yet Einstein's conclusion does hint at the impact of E equals mc squared when the speed of light is constant, and surely mass is capable of creating a huge amount of energy. However, technically, E is not equal to mc squared, because Einstein used the faulty gamma transform that he had derived in his previous paper of that same year, titled On the Electrodynamics of Moving Bodies, which defined what he called special relativity, abbreviated capital SR. In this previous paper, his derivation of the transform gamma was incorrect, because he failed to recognize that velocities are relative to coordinate systems, just like the spatial coordinates XYZ. After all, V equals S divided by T. Velocity is the change in space divided by the change in time. The fact that Einstein used the same V in his calculations when he needed to have two velocities, V and V prime, led him to miscalculate gamma as the transform. His error has existed in mainstream physics for over 100 years, and even now. Einstein's term for gamma is 1 over the square root of 1 minus V squared divided by C squared. Miles Mathis proves by correcting the math that the energy transform for Einstein's problem is actually kappa, and kappa equals 1 plus V prime squared divided by 2 C squared plus C V prime minus V prime squared. Therefore, ET equals M0 C squared times 1 plus V prime divided by 2C over 1 minus V prime squared divided by C squared. See Miles Mathis' paper in the link below. E is not equal to MC squared. Gamma is kappa, a complete redefinition of E equals MC squared. The difference between these two transforms is negligible over short distances, but at greater distances it breaks down, such as what causes NASA's so-called Pioneer anomaly. The observed derivation from the predicted accelerations of Pioneer 10 and Pioneer 11 spacecraft, after they passed about 20 astronomical units, was equivalent to a reduction of the outboard velocity by 1 kilometer per hour over a period of 10 years. And it's now explained away by vacuum pressure. The Jet Propulsion Lab had asked for help in understanding why the equations of relativity were yielding wrong numbers in their calculations on space satellites, but refused to accept the kappa of Miles Mathis, which correctly calculates the right numbers. Over time, Einstein, sadly, never found his error, and by adding tensor calculus to his derivation of gamma, made it even more difficult to find. All the higher abstruse math, such as hyperbolic fields, imaginary numbers, Hilbert spaces, Hamiltonians, and Lagrangians, have further disguised the simplicity of his mistake, or for that matter, the simplicity of the corrected solution. It is hoped that this brief paper will inspire you to read the proof of Einstein's error and its correct solution, as given by Miles Mathis, who is the author of these proofs. Thank you for listening, and I hope that you'll tune in for the next lecture.